Afternoon, drive heads. How's it going? This is a... Well, it's kind of a bittersweet episode. This is episode 4B, by the way. The fourth show we're doing. This is... it's May 23rd, just after 6 p.m. Eastern Standard in New Jersey, USA. And it's a nice... it turned into a pretty nice afternoon. Some of the ominous thunder... head type clouds have moved away, and looks to be a good evening, and I'm gonna just go home and go for a nice long run, I think, and miss any of this rain that might be still in the area somewhere, and get that going. I was a little negligent in my running last night. I know, I think I said on episode 3B that I was gonna definitely go for a run, but that didn't end up happening. But one funny thing that happened earlier was I actually had this completely recorded episode 4B and I during my lunch hour, and I was going to actually do a third installment of this day, trying to knock these talk shows out. I was actually going to do a third installment at this time, but this is really the second installment because it didn't record anything, and I was holding it up, and I actually did a whole 8-minute episode of expounding on the thoughts from this morning about the key to happiness, but I didn't get a single second of it. So I thought it was pretty good. So a little bittersweet that I'm talking to you now from the commute home, without the context of no one but me knowing anything about what I said earlier. So, I was just stopping. I saw some geese, and I also saw that box of crap was still there from yesterday, but I took the picture frames, but I didn't, and there's another thing there. I couldn't tell what it was, but I do have hoarding tendencies, so I have to kind of self-censor myself sometimes as far as when I'm picking up trash. I actually just picked up a little, in the parking lot outside my work, I picked up a little nugget. It was a little, It said it was a little like metal clasp thingy that looked like it was from a handbag, and it said Coach. I think Coach is a fancy type of handbag because it was a really nice little zipper tassel thing that I think came off of a purse. It said Coach. I'm not sure it's their logo. I'm not familiar with Coach too well, but that sounds familiar as far as it being a popular handbag. So I actually picked one of those up off the ground in the parking lot outside my office. So anyway, I do want to continue to, talking about, what I was talking about this morning, key to happiness, so forth. But as it turns out, I didn't get any of that in, but it really, and like I said, I think I made a lot of good points in the lunch thing. Just the darn thing was not recording, and I was talking, and it had it up to my mouth, and I must look like kind of like a bit of a crazy person dictating into his phone in his car alone on his lunch break, and that's fine, but none of it got down. But anyway, the gist of it was that it's all about the fight. So you're talking about this fight, fighting against the part of you that wants to just do nothing, or do things that basically equate to nothing. So all of the mindless things and all of the really unhealthy things that you wanted to maybe let yourself slide into because you feel sad and or tired, and you're mostly tired basically because of the depression of this horrible world, you know, or just the horrible. Reality that you maybe can't do what you want to do every single day, and not even close to it, not even like 20% of the time. So when you have to deal with that, sometimes you just want to shut down and you know, fill the void, these hours that you have in life, and just fill them up with nothingness, because you're so mad that you're kind of confined by things you don't feel like you can break free, that you let the moments that should count kind of slip into this even worse state, which is, you know, it's bad enough that you have to go and do a job that maybe you're not completely happy with, or it's, you know, it feels a little bit claustrophobic, just not an actual claustrophobic, but in a more metaphorical sense, that there's just no way out, no matter, you know, what's the end game as far as this 9-to-5 existence. You know, there isn't one. And, you know, if people are happy, and I assume some people are happy with certain 9-to-5 type jobs, is it a true happiness? I don't feel like this episode is as good as the one that didn't record at lunch. I really did want this to be a three-parter, and I guess today this session of episode was going to be episode C, but that's not how it worked out. I don't feel like I've nearly been as clear-cut, kind of putting the cherry on this fighting point. But the idea is that you're fighting it, so you're fighting these urges to do bad and to do things that become to nothingness. So that's really beginning and the end of it. You just have to keep fighting and hope that the fight turns. I compared it to like a boxing analogy. So sometimes, like a boxing match, you can win the fight, but if you look at the scorecard, something like, I don't know boxing at all, really, but I know a little bit enough to, like, make this analogy sort of work. So if the score's like 102-92, that doesn't seem like a lot, but you're the champ at the end, you're the winner. You won the fight, and it's mostly because you just took your punches and you went out there and you fought. So in the end, the fighting, the part that you're fighting against, when I outlaid that in the morning episode for our listeners, maybe if you're a new listener, you can go back vernonhell.com and follow the thread back to episode 4A to get a real good gist of what I was talking about there. But so it's all about the fight and it's about the struggle. So it's like when you get home, like when I get home right now and I'm pulling into my driveway in just another second here, I'm gonna go out and I'm gonna run. I'm gonna do like a 6-mile run. That's what I've told myself to do. And that's, if I don't do that, then I've already proven everything that I'm trying to say. And there's nothing left at that point. See what I mean? I'll see you tomorrow morning, or sometime tomorrow, probably. Bye.